Hello everyone, welcome back to the new topic, that is pressure in the surrounding formation. In the previous videos we had seen the Harness plotting technique. It was three reasons where we were talking in detail. We talked about the middle time region, where estimation of permeability, skin and other related parameter was there. And in the early time region, where well bore storage effect was there. In the last video we had seen how to estimate the time for which this well bore effect will be distorting the transient data in the early time region. This calculation of well bore distortion time is very important to estimate that when that MTR region will start, and also when there was deviation from this straight line on the Harness plot. This is the time and corresponding radius of investigation where we feel the boundary effect. And today we will talk more about this late time region and how to estimate the pressure in the surrounding formation. Surrounding means, that means it is in the reach of the pressure transient, but we call near to that well where the investigation is going on, particularly the well testing process. So when we talk about pressure, we talk it at the two level. First is at the well level, another is at the reservoir level. A reservoir has several wells. Here you could see that this reservoir has four wells, and these four wells is making a fluid boundary, that is intangible boundary, fluid boundary, and this well will have pressure and drawing the fluid from this region only, and this well will have average pressure in this region, and similarly this well have pressure drawn down in this region. When we talk about this transient analysis technique, particularly we apply these three techniques. We had seen the pressure buildup technique. We will look into the RFT, SFT. RFT is a Schlumberger tool and SFT is a Halliburton tool. That's called PLT, production logging tool. It's a kind of production logging tool. Also, it's a DST, which is a kind of earlier version of RFT. We will look into detail later in the discussion. But here you understand that we apply this transient technique to estimate the pressure for a particular well in the nearby formation, or the pressure which is decreased because of this particular well. So when substantial quantity of fluid withdrawn from the near to that well, we will see that average pressure has decreased. But if the well is newly drilled, the pressure will be the original reservoir pressure. Otherwise, we will get the average static drainage area pressure. That is denoted by the P bar, and the original reservoir pressure is denoted by the PI, that is initial pressure. So, and when we estimate this P bar, average P bar for this particular well, and similarly this average static drainage area pressure could be estimated for different well, and it could be averaged out volumetrically, or quantity of production, or the rate at which this production is going on, or the aerial, different kind of weighted method is there. You can read more about it, or I will share the link from the PetroWiki how to estimate this average reservoir level pressure. And this average, when we talk about the management, this average reservoir level is more important than this specific well. But when we look the well to well, particularly for the production maintenance, we look which well is performing well or which well is not. This average pressure at the particular well is very much important to look into. So I told you that's the original reservoir pressure and the average static drainage area pressure. In original reservoir pressure, if there is no boundary, and this kind of will be there when mostly the reservoir which is infinite in acting, or even reservoir is bonded but new reservoir is there, and where negligible pressure depletion is there. This is only where if you extrapolate the middle time region or the late time region, we will get the initial pressure. Here you could look at. It is only when this log 1 in Horner's plotting technique, log 1 will be when delta T will be very large. That means the well is shut in for long enough so that the transient has sufficiently reached into the far away into the reservoir, and this is where the initial reservoir pressure is there. And when this well is shut in for longer period of time, that means this longer period of time the radiation investigation is traveled deep into the reservoir and no boundary is felt by this transient, or negligible pressure drop is there far away from the well. In that case only, if there is no boundary, in this case you will see even middle time region deviation is not there. That means no boundary effect is there. The extrapolation of this line will get the initial reservoir pressure. We can't shut in our well for infinite delta T because it will be impractical or impossible to achieve. But we could do that, we will shut in the well for sufficiently long time, like there is an average well to well distance, that is 250 meter or 500 meter. For that average well to well distance, we calculate the radius of investigation and corresponding time for this particular reservoir type. We produce the well and then extrapolate it for the later time region. Here even you could see that the boundary is felt by this transient, but we call it initial reservoir pressure because this is new bonded reservoir only. But when we come to average static drainage area pressure, it is either applied for either infinite acting reservoir or bonded reservoir. When partial or some pressure depletion is there that we estimate at infinite certain time, or when this Horner's time ratio will approach to 1. And particularly here you could see this is the Horner's plotting technique, where this straight line region where this Horner's data is gaining that middle time region, we extrapolate this and middle time region, and whenever it is meeting that infinite certain time, we call it the P star. This is Horner's extrapolated pressure. This P star is somewhat related to the average drainage area pressure, but not equal to. This is imaginary pressure. But when we set in the well, actually setting the well for longer period of time, then this will meet this log 1 value in actual, and this will give you the actual average reservoir pressure. But one of the important task here to discuss is how to estimate this average reservoir pressure with this P star value. Getting the P star is very easy, because when we extrapolate the this middle time region only, we get this P star. But we can't sit in the well practically for longer period of time to get this average reservoir pressure that is actually existing inside the reservoir. So our task is to how can we estimate this P bar from the P star. So method of estimating this P bar, average static drainage area pressure, from P star, or directly another way, is categorized into two types. First is using the data from middle time region, and second is using the data from late time region. Using this middle time region, we apply this MBS method, that is kind of P star method, and second is Ramey's and Cobb method, which also the middle time region method. And second is using the data from LTR region, that is modified Muscat method, and R Smith method. Here in this particular lecture, we will talk about this MBS method and the modified Muscat method. I will leave to you to refer any book and read yourself based on your interest about Remy's Cobb method and ARP speed method. So, I am talking about this P star, and our objective is to determine the static reservoir pressure of unknown geometry, because in the beginning we are not knowing what kind of geometry is there, but we can somewhat guess that what kind of geometry is there based on the seismic data. Without waiting week or months for well to get stabilized, that means we can't sustain our well for longer period of time, month or 2 months or 3 months, so that we get actually the average static reservoir pressure. So our job, our objective is to determine this static reservoir pressure from this other P star method or other methods. So I was talking about this P star. This P star has no physical meaning. I mean, like we are talking about this TP value, or not producing time. This has had some physical meaning, but this P star has no physical meaning. We can't explain it, the physics behind it. So it is only the extrapolated line over this middle time region, and when it is intersecting at log 1 on Horner's time, we don't denote it with the P star. It is also called the imaginary pressure, the extrapolated pressure from Horner's extrapolated pressure. And PI will be actually producing the well for a longer period of time, sufficient certain time will require to get the well to stabilized at that pressure, initial reservoir pressure or the P bar, actual pressure, that we call the actual pressure. So in this MBS method, MBS has actually computed a series of buildup curve from the model, and they compared it to estimate the calculation of static drainage area pressure from the P star. So I will just show you that the MBS actually developed that curve, series of buildup curve between PMBH versus T dimensionless time. TP is the dimensionless Horner's producing time, and MBH is actually P star minus P bar divided by 70.6 Q mu B by KH. If you multiply denominator and numerator by 2.303, then we will reduce down to this part, and here if you multiply 70.6 with 2.303, you will get this 162.6 Q mu B by KS, that is the slope of that Horner's plot, and it will be reduced down to M, that is the slope of Horner's plot. So this MBH is 2.303 bracket P star minus P bar divided by slope. Here if we anyhow we know this P MBH, pressure MBH, and we know the P star, we can calculate back this P bar average, that is average static drainage area pressure. So this is one kind of, you know, that series of curve generated by this MBH approach between this dimensionless TP and this MBH pressure. This dimensionless pressure is P star minus P bar divided by 70.6 Q mu B by KS that I just explained to you. Here you could see that different kind of geometry, it's called reservoir shape, like rhombus, right triangle, equilateral triangle, square or hexagon or circle, different kind of curves are there. So when we choose that particular curve, we need to have a general guess or a confident guess in between that which kind of curve we need to choose to calculate that average reservoir, static reservoir pressure from that P star method. So this is another, like even a square boundary is there, but well is not centered. Like here you could see that well is centered, but here well is not centered in these three cases. And when well is not centered, we had seen in earlier discussion that the pressure could be differently behaved. Also here a rectangular kind of boundary is there, and generally 4:1 rectangular boundary. And if this is the center one, this is not center, these three cases, and pressure will behave differently. This is again rectangular, but it is 2:1 type of rectangular. That means their breadth is twice the length of this rectangular. Here again, this if the well is not centered, pressure will behave differently. And knowing the and TP value and reservoir fluid and rock properties, like to calculate that TP value, what you need is this phi, porosity, viscosity, total compressibility, area from which fluid is withdrawing, and the permeability, and then TP, that is the corners producing time. To calculate this time of dimensionless corners producing time. So there are following steps that we need to follow to in the MBS method to estimate that average static drainage area pressure. First, what we do, we extrapolate the middle time region in general Horner's plot, and wherever is touching the line at Horner's time ratio at 1, we read this P star value. I showed you what is P star. And then we general guess is taken for this drainage area shape from this seismic or other data set. And we choose this proper MBS method curve for this drainage area shape. That the curve I just shown to you, this kind of curve. We choose this particular curve for different drainage area shape. And then we estimate this dimensionless Horner's producing time using the rock and fluid properties, and knowing the area of this particular drainage area shape. And then knowing the dimensionless producing Horner's producing time, here you could see that if you know this particular value, we can, if it is 0.2, you can go back and select the particular curve. Like if square is there, we will go choosing this particular line, and at 0.2 it will read back to the dimensionless pressure, and we equate this pressure, that is called PMBS dimensionless, to calculate this static drainage area pressure. And from here only you will get this P bar equal to average static drainage area pressure equal to P star, that is the extrapolated Horner's pressure, minus slope, Horner's slope, divided by 2.303, to PMBS that we had just read from this system of curve for this particular areas drainage area shape for this TP value. And then we put back, we can estimate this P bar. Here is an example for this particular MBH method. Here you can see that this Horner's plot is given, for which this P star value extrapolated middle time region value is 2689.4 psi, and the slope is 26.7 per cycle. And TP value for which the well was producing before setting is 482 hours. And different reservoir rock and fluid properties are given, and even area is given. I've been mentioning that it is 2:1 rectangular reservoir, and it is centered in this rectangular. So what you could do, we can estimate this TP, dimensionless TP value, using this TP value, and then knowing the area for this area is given, you can estimate this TP value, which is coming out is 0.35. And from this TP value, we apply on particular that curve, MBH curve. Here you can see that for a rectangular, 2 into 1 rectangular is there. For we choose this plot for 2 into 1 rectangular, and it is centered. So this is the particular plot for this rectangular boundary, reservoir boundary. So we choose this black line for estimating this PMBH. So this T dimensionless pseudo honors producing time was 0.35. So it is somewhere here. This 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, it is 0.4. So 0.35 will be in between these two line, and it is somewhere here. So corresponding to this 0.35, if you go back to this line and calculate this PMBH, it is coming 2.05. And we apply this 2.05 here, and we estimate this P bar, that is average static energy depletion. So it is simple. You can choose other geometry or other different kind of data set. You need to follow the same step to calculate this average static drainage area pressure. So in the next part, I will discuss the other method to how to estimate this average drainage area pressure. Just tune in. If you have any doubt, let me know, or you can write in the comment box. This is all for the discussion, and other part will be discussed next video. Thank you.